morning. So, are we all ready? Because we are. So I'm Antonio Zamperla, CEO of the Zamperla Group. And first of all, thank you for being here, since we have some exciting news to share with you. We have been managed to keep pace with technological evolution and the needs of increasingly competitive market while maintaining our identity. This year, the Zamperla Group turns 55 years old since my grandfather founded the company. We expanded from a small, tiny Italian company to a global group that delivers every year more than 200 rides all over the world. The company has always been known for its product innovation, and during the pandemic, we didn't stop or sit still. We enhanced our presence worldwide with augmented reality assistance that permit us to install more than 20 rides from remote and rolled out the connected ride program that will help our customers lowering their total cost of ownership as well as downtimes. On the rides development side, until this presentation, we unveiled 7 totally brand new rides and the total re-engineering of our coaster department. But we are here today because we want to present you some more new products that we have developed. And to hear about that, let me introduce you Michael Coleman, Sales Manager for the North America, and then Adam Sandy, Marketing and Roller Coaster Director for the Roller Coaster Division. Thank you all.
Thank you, Antonio. It is an honor to be here with you all today. I missed you all last year when we were sitting behind our computer screens on Zoom and Teams and other platforms. So this is a real privilege for me. Representing the Zamperla team up here is representing a global entity. And over the last year, we've announced some new attractions via our social media channels during a thing we like to call Z Fun Week. And this is a culmination of that collective perseverance. So in our booth, you will see one of the Z Fun Week additions, which is the Pump and Jump, which will be at Adventureland Resort in 2022. Oh. And that is going to be one of 8 new attractions, signifying the strength of our industry, the resilience, and the desire to continue pushing forward. With that Z Fun Week, we've also launched the Griffin, which is a new 24 capacity thrill ride, the Blendez, and the Kronos. These rides will be making debuts in 2022 and 2023 at other parks, and I invite you to come over to our booth and see. One of the new ones for this Z Fun Week here with you all today is the Zeta Swing. It's going to be the world's largest pendulum ride, coming in at just under 200 feet with speeds nearly 60 miles per hour. It'll be available in a 16 and 32 capacity. And I'm gonna let the video do some of the talking for me and then step back in.
Yeah.
I'm in the Zeta Swing. And now I would like to introduce to you Mr. Z Funweek himself, one of my newest colleagues and a good friend, Adam Sandy.
Thank you, brother. All right, we're actually back in person at IAAPA. It's nice, isn't it? And we're here to share some great stuff. So I'm Adam Sandy, the roller coaster sales and marketing director for Zamperla. I've been here since January and it's been a blast. But I actually came to the company because when I looked around and saw where do I want to go next, I started to talk to Zamperla. And I found out that they'd been investing in the roller coaster division for the past 5 years. And that meant they'd invested in two key areas, team and technology. Our team is fantastic. We actually now have one of the largest engineering groups in-house in the attractions industry designing roller coasters. They're not only great people with great minds, they love coasters, and they are the ones who've come up with all the concepts we're sharing today. Second is technology. We've actually brought a majority of our fabrication in-house so we can lower costs and make sure that we have the best track in the industry. And I know we've got some great competition on this floor, but I think we've got some great things to share. The other big thing that we're doing when we change how we look at roller coasters is customer collaboration. What I mean by that is we're working closer with our partners than ever before. We've been around for 55 years, and I think understanding our customers' needs is important, and we brought that into the roller coaster realm as well. Accessibility is obviously a huge issue in our industry, and we want everyone to ride. That's why we brought a lot of our technology over from the flat rides into coasters to make sure that we have the most accessible roller coasters in the attractions industry. Looking forward, we can say that new Zamperla roller coasters are going to have three main features. The first, they're going to be great rides. As we said, we've done some good coasters, we've done some not so good ones, but we're really excited because moving forward, we want to build some of the best roller coasters in the industry. Second, we're providing marketable experiences. We understand that when a park invests in a coaster, it's not a small expense. It's millions of dollars for the ride itself, as well as all the other ancillary costs. We're making sure that when we move forward, we create coasters that are great rides, and they're really marketable, and they're inherently viral in their experience. So they've got something to enjoy, a story to tell. Whether it's our new family throw launch, we're gonna showcase in a second, the really tall double heart, we've made sure that our attractions are going to stand out from the competitors in the industry and park's regional competitors. Third, and this is the most important, but probably least sexy thing I'm going to talk about, is cost of ownership. We understand that cost dynamics have changed, especially in the last 18 months. Running a park is very different than it used to be. And we're in a very unique situation. We're the only major manufacturer that operates amusement parks and manufactures attractions. We've learned so much by operating Luna Park and other parks around the world. What we found is that so often, the people who engineer the rides and the people who operate the rides often don't talk unless there's a problem. What we've tried to do is bring that together and better understand how we can improve our product day to day for operations and maintenance. But this isn't just something we're giving lip service to. I want you all to go over to our booth, 2224, check out the Lightning vehicle. It's got some really basic improvements like padding that's easy to change and affordable, but also look under the hood, kick the tires. Check out the aluminum milled chassis, the aluminum milled bogies. Those are really important because they reduce NDT costs, non-destructive testing, and they also change the dynamic when you think about maintenance, operation, cost, and labor. All of those things, when you pull together, makes owning a roller coaster extremely expensive and complex. And we're trying to make that entire process much easier for people who own our rides. Now, I can say that we've come up with some great concepts. You know, recently we debuted our family coaster Lift Launch, which will open at a major North American park in 2022. It's 36 inches to ride, really fun, and one of the only kiddie coasters out there with a launch. Second is this, the Double Heart Coaster. We showcased this as part of Z Fun Week in June. We have two models, 70 meters, so about 230 feet, a real hyper coaster, as well as a 50 meter model, which is 164 feet. Both are gonna be fantastic experiences. We think they're the boldest Zamperla coasters we've come up with to date. I love them for a few reasons. First, obviously, the experience. We have coasters that are offering something very different than our competitors. I love the ride because it starts out with three launches, two forward, one backward. After that, you're going to go up over the top, experience some awesome negative Gs. Elisa, our key mathematician who's behind all the roller coasters, loves negatives, and you're going to pop over the top and feel it. It's going to be great. After that, we have a twisting vertical dive that heads straight toward the ground, and then two inversions, an Immelmann and a dive loop. All of these things are going to combine to offer a fantastic coaster experience in a very compact footprint. In addition, this is going to offer fantastic capacity. I love it because our one train model can offer 500 to 600 people per hour. The two train versions with the turntable you saw can do up to 1,000 people per hour. These aren't just numbers on paper. These are practical applications you can do with the roller coaster. If you check out the Lightning vehicle, you see the rows are really wide between the seats. The seats are really comfortable. And from an operator's perspective, you can actually move people through the ride. I know I've been involved in projects before. We had a theoretical capacity that was one level and a practical capacity that was quite different. We're working to make sure that all the rides that we put forward can really meet the spec sheets that are on paper. And third, we're thrilled to introduce the Family Thrill Launch Coaster. This is the newest coaster from Zamperla's family of coaster attractions. I love this because I'm the dad of a stubbornly short 5-year-old daughter. She barely got over 42 inches this year, and I love taking her to parks. But when we visit, we notice something. There are tons of kiddie coasters that are 36 inches to ride. Where do the thrill coasters start at 48 inches? There's this huge gulf in between of attractions that we're missing for kids, and we want to get them on coasters. And I think when you look at this concept, you can see it's going to be thrilling for those kids that are 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, but also a lot of fun for teens, tweens, and young adults. It's a coaster that speaks to everybody. You know, over 60 years ago, Morgan and Bacon of Aero developed the Mine Train at Six Flags Over Texas, and it revolutionized the roller coaster industry. We think the Family Thrill Launch is going to do that for us, too. We think it's going to bring a new generation of coaster riders to the table, and they're going to love what this ride has to offer. It has some really great marketable features also. As you can see here, we start out with a backwards launch, go up a dead-end spike, and through a forwards launch. It's a great marketable asset for a park to have. After that, it's a fantastic layout. We can do custom layout to make it fit. This is the sample that we're offering on the show floor. I love it because it really enhances the experience by having low slung turns toward the end of the experience, but it's also got great capacity. We have two models, one with around 900 people per hour and one with almost 1,200. But I think the coolest thing about this ride are the vehicles. We're offering three different vehicle types, which you'll see in a moment: motorcycle, sidecar, and truck. And with all of these, we're offering great experiences because with the sidecar, for instance, kids can actually choose the adventure they want to have. They can get in the sidecar, get in the motorcycle, make it their own choice. And when you get kids engaged in the attraction, when they get to choose what they want to ride, they have a better day and they want to come back. We're really happy with the Family Thrill Launch, and it's got a lot of fantastic attributes. The other thing I want to say about it is that what we're doing on a lot of these new Zamperla coasters is using existing technology. The switch, the tire drive launch, the vehicle, the restraint, they're all being put together for the first time in a unique way, but it's all existing Zamperla technology. We have over 5 decades of experience with rides and attractions, and we're pulling all of that together to make sure that our rides have fantastic uptime, use proven technology, and are fun. We're really proud of the Family Thrill Launch. We invite you to stop by, talk a little bit more about it. We're happy to answer any questions, and we're really excited about this next generation of Zamperla coasters. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, I've been told if you need press release info, we got some over there. Stop by, pick one up. Thanks again, everybody. We appreciate you coming.